Oh, hello, Dracula fans. Are you in for a real treatment? Sorry, let's continue. The story is about John Morris, a blindfold vampire hunter that wants to overcome Dracula and destroy him. As for his other partner, that wants revenge. Of the Dracula curse that settled on his wife and got turned into a physical vampire. Yearly, after Castlevania IV, this game doesn't really have a story. Since the 2D platformers just catched on with the gameplay, the hot sauce gameplay. If you're ready to face up another Castlevania madness, then this game is for you. The Face of Featuring Monsters is placeable to be the most creative foes yet. The backgrounds are monstrous. Looks like an old vampire movie with special effects. The board of all this is 6 stages. Yes, it's short, but the levels seem longer than Castlevania other games, such as IV. The bosses are non-stop pests that will throw a dive and game an axe at you. One will test your card knowledge, and shit, even Dracula can throw a punch. And he's serious this time. The stages are forested greatness. I love the climbing up tower level, the sinking abyss level, the mechanical level, and so much more to resemble the memories. The Genesis Classic had to be the most approvable creative masterpiece I've seen so by far. I might as well fire my art director and hire one of the Castlevania artists. What? I need a balance in my life. The beginning levels are alright. Maximumly, I say the lady levers are going to bat you up and spit you out like a garden fly. You're imposing a threat in this game. Be prepared to die. The boss will match up perfectly and will confuse you to a death throne. The enemies are pain annoying as a patching orange. All I say is this game, is it going to be a bitch? A literally bitch? Yes, it's a bitch. Now, I still have trouble with the menacing enemies, even though I'm a Castlevania fan. But let me just tell you, this game is a bitch. I'm telling you this right away. Copying your abilities, getting special power-ups, won't help. These bastards will kick your ass. The sound is capable to hide up some volume on your 2012 stereo. The tunes are heavenly great. I always love video games when they have atmosphere, and it matches ragingly possibly a good check off my naughty list. The sound effects are even granted with grand spheres. Too much of that won't even give you a heartache in your stomach. The hope of this music is the last great generation of our time. We all hear melodies, but the SNES era and Genesis will always be fueled by a cherished heart. The final verdict is you get abilities, special power-ups, banging head bosses, enemies that are creepily annoying, levels that are pushingly designed, the bar is raised, the ending's priceless, this video game is delivering a box of fun to your Wii consoles or Sega Genesis systems. If you're a big loyal Castlevania fangirl or fanboy, pick this one up now. It gets a 6.5 story, gameplay gets a 10.0, difficulty gets a 9.0, sound gets a 10.0, and my final review score is a 9.5. Check this out on a database, or hell, find it used at a hard retail shop. That is my review. Let the blood veins of vampires make more sequels for Halloween madness.